I can always put the intermission up as well. All right. OBS is green. Twitch is green. YouTube is green. You've got alert 1. I've got alert 2. And our intermission page is live while you're looking at that. Good evening, sports fans. Welcome to League 1, Season 14, Week 9. We'll be kicking off shortly with number 12, Florida State, at number 3, Syracuse. And we're going to follow that up with Tulsa at Navy later tonight. First off, a quick examination of the Florida State Seminoles roster through the eyes of the head coach of the Syracuse Orange Men, Coach Spectre.
Good evening, sports fans. We've got an exciting doubleheader tonight for you. A couple of conference games leading off with, as Coach Ninja just said, number 12 Florida State at number 3 Syracuse. Florida State led by an outstanding quarterback in DeAndre Francois. He's a 96 overall. He's got some legs and 86 awareness. A pretty well-balanced quarterback who's off to a hot start. 14-3 touchdowns to interceptions ratio and a 177 rating is outstanding for a quarterback. Although he's only throwing for 156 yards, he's quite effective when he throws. Rushing wise, 24, almost 25 yards a game. Looks like he will take off when need be, and he's effective when he does, but not necessarily centered on running. Cam Akers, the leading halfback with 95 speed, a speed back averaging 86 yards a game on the ground with 7 touchdowns, and some movement in the passing game. Kalon LeBourne also contributes 62 yards a game on the ground, not a small factor, the backup halfback, and a little bit more of a power back, a little bit bigger, and a little bit more of a different style of runner than Akers' outright speed. At fullback, Gabe Neighbors, with 84 overall, should be quite an effective halfback. The leading receiver is Keith Gavin. He's an All-American, averaging nearly 100 yards a game. They like to throw to him quite often, and he is very good at it. Campbell, though, the burner with 98 speed, will be a threat for the big play. He is loaded with athleticism. He's getting only 24 yards a game, but we expect that he might break open once or twice and rip off a couple of big plays against us today. DJ Matthews, the third receiver, and McKitty coming in as a tight end playing fourth wide receiver in some of those spread sets. He is the backup tight end, a little bit more athletic than the starter, Aaron Brown, who's getting about 36 yards a game, somewhat active in the passing game. The offensive line from left to right, Russell's an 83, sophomore. Landon Dickerson, an outstanding 97 left guard. An 89, Babyon Johnson at center. And David Robbins will be out for the game, but replaced by an 84, backup Baselli, Andrew Baselli, a possible relation to Tony Baselli, playing on the offensive line there at right guard. Mike Harrison, the sophomore, 83, playing at right tackle. So a few sophomores there with a 97 upperclassman at left guard. Looks to be a fairly solid offensive line. 83 sophomores tend to overperform. Brian Burns, incredibly athletic with 81 speed and a 97 overall left end. We expect him to contain the scramble to the right very well. He's smart with 90 awareness. He's athletic and a threat for sacks. Jalen Wilkerson, a 91 right end, gives them two bookends, a 92 and an 86 at D tackle, an 85 at left outside linebacker impact player, along with Adonis Thomas, a 91 overall middle linebacker with 91 awareness. if they run four linebackers. Dontavius Jackson is an excellent fourth linebacker as a 91 middle linebacker himself. Emmett Rice, an 89 right outside linebacker, rounds out a very, very good linebacking core for the Seminoles. And Kyle Myers and Levante Taylor, 92 and 91 at corner, with Becker III, an 88 nickel corner, an excellent set of corners there for the Seminoles. Derwin James Jr., in this universe, came back for his senior year, was not drafted in the top 15, and is an incredible player. Number three free safety, one to watch for. He should be all over the field. He comes in on a hot streak, should be playing his A game. Cyrus Fagan, an 89 strong safety, rounds out a spectacular secondary. We'll give him an A-plus in the secondary. We'll give him an A-minus in linebackers and an A-minus on the defensive line. An outstanding defense all around with no visible weaknesses should provide quite the challenge. Ricky Aguayo also came back for his senior year and is a 94 kicker. Hasn't gotten the yips for the Buccaneers yet. And as we know, had quite the college career. Logan Tyler rounding it out as the punter. And that is your look at an outstanding, very highly rated Florida State team with weapons all over the place on offense and nobody below an 88 on defense. So we expect all the game in the world from the Seminoles. We're going to try to win it by any margin possible. We are at home. We have multiple, many, many recruits visiting this week. Six, in fact, that are visiting. There are quite some big prospects there. And we hope to do the best that we can to perform for them. Without any further ado, I'll throw it back over to Coach Ninja. He'll give you the play-by-play, the voice of the Orangemen football. And we'll get this first game of our doubleheader underway. You can look forward to, following the game, the Tulsa-Navy matchup, a key American Conference game.
Thank you, Coach. As you can see here, a number of high ratings on both sides of the ball. Number 6 in points for the Orange, but number 21 in total offense for the Seminoles on defense. Total defense number 1 and number 2 for rushing and total, but negative 4 in turnovers is a deficit for the Seminoles that the Orangemen will hope to exploit. Coach R. Bark says good luck as these two 99-99 teams kick off. Seminoles, number 16 in the country in points, going up against number 6. And on defense, it's number 35 in points versus number 9. A very good rushing offense compared to a very good rushing defense between the Orange and the Seminoles, both of which in the 20s. Stephen Lloyd, number 2 center in the country, and Marcus Ryan, Jamal Smith, 3 of the 6 recruits here for the Orange at the Carrier Dome. Huff Richter, Custis, and Lofton, highest-rated players for the home team, versus James, Dickerson, and Burns, as the three highest-rated Seminoles making the travel to upstate New York.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Syracuse has been on a roll lately.
This is number 1 and number 2 in the Atlantic Conference of the ACC.
most storied legacies in the history of college football.
I started my coaching career, I had a dream. And every decision that I made, that I will be the head football coach of Syracuse University. Undefeated, untied.
1959 national champions.
Syracuse has scored an undefeated season, and the team carries Ben Swartzwelder off the field.
It's going to be the greatest victory that you kids have ever had.
Dozens of the most prolific and impactful players in the game. The first African-American to win the Heisman Trophy. Six members of the Pro Football Hall of Fame. 53 All-America selections.
We need to make this place the hardest place to play in the country. We need you. We need everyone. This is our state, our town, our team, and we gotta win. Now, go Orange!
Spanning more than 10 successful seasons and covering the country from California, Ohio, North Carolina, and Virginia, this is League One NCAA football.
Don't you let anyone steal history away from you.
Since 1889, this is Syracuse football.
With the Orange winning the toss, they elect to defer, and it's going to be Florida State ball to start the game. Single back, four wide receivers, and it's a pass to Gavin, 25 yards and a lob into space by DeAndre Francois. Already beginning to stretch the field, number 13 coming up with a great tackle. Frederick on the tackle.
First and 10, ball on the 50.
After one play, they're now in enemy territory. Handoff this time is to Cam Akers. He gets 13 yards, and it takes a couple of men to bring him down.
It's the one thing you just can't defend.
From the 37-yard line, it's first down.
Tight ended now on the left. As they hand off to Akers up the middle, he's got space. And he gets another 12 yards and a first down. I'm not so sure about that. It's only been three plays.
From the 24-yard line, first down.
Bunch receivers this time. And Green comes in and gets the ankles for the first sack of the game.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. Another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Yeah. Hey, I'm gonna get to do another one bites the dust. Shoot up.
Now, second and 8. From the 33. Big down for wide receivers. And it's just thrown away. It's now going to be a third and very long for the Orange. This is exactly what they wanted, to slow down this fast first drive for the Seminoles. Three down linemen now, as you see tight end, halfback, both on the left. Francois holds on to it for too long, and it's a big sack, and this may put them at, yeah, looks like it's probably out of field goal ranges. You see Green 91 there getting off his blocker, make it fourth and 26. Seminoles putting a long field goal on the field. He has the distance, but it goes wide.
Atlantic Coast Conference action in the spotlight. And for Wake Forest, they won two straight. And for Newman, he hit the 200-yard mark passing. Wake Forest grabs the victory by a field goal.
Thanks, Reese. No score in this one.
Excellent field position now on their own 40-yard line to start their first drive. An excellent defensive hold by the Orange after a bang, bang, bang. First three plays by the Seminoles. Tanuvasa scrambles out. He waits, and he tosses it to Lofton. Lofton, on the slant in man coverage, had the space. It was more of a question of could Tanuvasa find the time to throw it, and he did. And with 20 yards, they go from their own 40 to the enemy 40.
First and 10, all on the 40-yard line.
Four wide, single back, handoff to Neal up the middle. He gets 6 yards and is sandwiched between two guys closing in. Shotgun ace now, Lofton in motion left to right. Pitch is late, Lofton does a good job to get it. It's a 2 yard gain to make it third and short though. I should say, Tanuvasa does a great job to make sure the pitch gets off. It looked pretty late.
So it's third down and they've got about 2 yards to go. Five wide. He's on the run. He's under pressure. He's at the 20. He's pushed out of bounds.
Tanuvasa has the drag, but he likes the scramble and gets more yardage that way with great downfield blocking by his wide receivers and a uncalled penalty on the late hit. We now see Culpepper out in the spread flex. And it's a handoff to Neal. He's got lots of space. He gets 12 yards. It's first and goal from inches on a great run by Mo Neal. Five wide receivers now for Tanuvasa back in the game. Drag route to Custis, easy as you please. Hoffrichter tacks on the extra point, but is disappointed as I now see that he is handing, I think it's, it's Jamal Custis. He's handing him a $1 bill for missing the gap in the R on that kickoff.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind.
Tight end left, halfback right. Handoff is to the halfback, hit in the backfield, taken down by the second man, really, and his own line being stalled. It's a 0 yard gain, the first 0 yard gain of the game for Cam Akers, the impact running back.
second down.
Four wide receivers, single back now. Green just a little late. It's a 14-yard reception to Trey McKitty as DeAndre Francois gets the ball out very quick to the curl route, 10 yards deep.
From their own 39-yard line, first down.
Five wide receivers now. Francois forced out of the pocket. And Bailey jumps the route of the flat pass. And that's a defensive touchdown by Champ Bailey, the corner. Richter trying to get in quick, almost shanks the extra point. Syracuse off to a hot start after a couple of rough plays on defense for 50 yards. I think exactly 50 yards. Turned it around, got a couple of sacks and a missed field goal and a pick six. Another play into the flat. Campbell gets missed by the first defender, and the second man makes a great play to come and take out his legs. Derek Thomas saving it to second and one.
Situation here. It's second down and one. Slings it. He's knocked out of bounds around the 49-yard line.
Another pass out into space on the sideline to DJ Matthews goes for 14 yards before being pushed out of bounds. DeAndre Francois, 4 for 6, seems to like the space at the side of the field. This time, with lots of coverage and no options, decides he doesn't like anything and sends the ball out of bounds. Second and 10 now. Two halfbacks in the backfield, three wide receivers spread out. Campbell, 23-yard catch on the lob pass. Scoop Bradshaw got faked to the inside and couldn't catch up. Four wide receivers, Akers in the backfield. Hand off to Akers, and he's tackled, and they call it both a 0-yard gain and a loss. So he lost less than a yard. It's now second and 10. Another handoff to Akers, and this time it's a full loss of a yard, and it's going to be third and long again. Excellent tackle out in space by Henderson Jr., the only man who was going to stop Akers from getting the first down, or most of it. And Campbell gets just enough space between the safety and his man to catch the touchdown. Francois with a fantastic pass exactly where it needed to be for SSU to get the points they needed to keep this a ball game. The question is somebody about to kick? I would, you know, if I was either coach, I would hope, yep, no, I'm about to kick with 1 second, thank you. I'm on the 2 yard line, I'm just going to kick this. Schumacher way deep, elects to run for it. There's a free man who just came unblocked on the left edge. Tackles Schumacher on the 12. Means that Syracuse Orange will have a fair distance to go, starting with 2:07 left to go in the first, coming out in the ace. Shotgun ace, I should say. Tanuvasic keeps it and couldn't get the pitch off. It was a dangerous pitch anyway, with a defender closing from behind him. It's now 2nd and 11. Shotgun normal now. Metcalf out of the backfield. He gets a 2 yard gain before being swallowed up by defenders coming off their blockers. 3rd and 9 now for the Orange. Coming out in an I formation, tight end on the right against 4 down linemen. Tanuvasa makes a great throw and a great catch by Lofton, who is covered well at the time to escape the impending sack. That's a big play by Tanuvasa and Lofton to make that work, closely covered as both of them were. Shotgun wide trips this time. Tanuvasa decides he likes the scramble into space, and he throws to Custis when he gets beyond the hashes for a big gain. Excellent display of breaking power by Tommy Tanuvasa to make sure he stops short of the line of scrimmage. We now see the shotgun split big. Tanuvasa keeps it, elects to go outside, and loses 3 yards when the defenders are all in the space. Second and 13. We'll see if they want to play. And they do. Tanuvasa scrambling out. He is being chased, but he has the time and the space to get 14 yards to end the first quarter.
The scoreboard lit up in that first 15 minutes. 14-7, Syracuse.
The enemy's 39-yard line now. Only for the second time because of the defensive touchdown.
Is up a score.
Metcalf out of the backfield on the wide trips, catches the angle route. He's good for the first down, and he makes the spin move to change from inside to outside at the right time, add another 5 yards to the play. Syracuse Orange now on the 23-yard line, 7 points ahead.
From the 23-yard line, first down.
Shotgun ace now. Another angle to Metcalf, another spin move for an extra couple yards. This time it's the difference between 7 and 10. First and 10 now from the 13, 7:09 in the second. Read option, Tanuvasa keeps it. He gets bounced from the side, but he still gets the first down. They prevent him from going over the plane. It is first and goal now from the 2. Another great first and goal opportunity for the Orange. They were first and goal from inches last time around. Five wide receivers again this time. Tanuvasa doesn't like the look, and he runs it for the touchdown.
By the power of Grayskull, Gringer became the mighty Battle Cat, and I became He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe. Only three others share this secret.
Let's have a look at what's going on in Chapel Thrill. This was a tight one to the very end. The Tar Heels win it, 23-20.
All right, Reese, back to our game.
And back to a two-score lead. Syracuse kick off to the Seminoles with 6:39 remaining.
He sends this one deep.
Deep in the end zone, Becker takes the knee. Hit as he throws, Brown breaks a tackle, and they call him past the down marker.
But he stood his ground and found his teammate for a nice game.
Seems like it's usually when you start to turn.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36.
Too many bodies for Akers to escape, and it's a loss of one. Akers in the backfield, same side as the tight end. And Gavin catches the curl and turns it for 13 yards when DeAndre Francois has some time. Killing Zombies. He-Man is touchdown music, and as such, it is rationed out. So the sound effects in this game, because this is a competitive league, as Matthews makes a great catch and breaks a couple of tackles. The sound effects are restricted to myself. But Coach Spectre, the coach of the Syracuse Orange, said he's going to do his best to make sure that gets another touchdown, so you can hear that again. And Green forces the bad throw. Foster gets his hands up, and that's the second pick of the game for the Orange. Evan Foster, the strong safety. Out of the five wide, Tanuvasa waits in the pocket this time. Unusual, he likes to scramble a lot, and he waits for Lofton to get into space when he breaks. Lofton making a great spin move to extend the play, now deep in enemy territory after starting on their own 40. Sorry, they're on 30. Metcalf out of the backfield only gets two this time. Four-yard rush from Mo Neal gets, as I just said, 4 yards. It's now third and three. Mefield English? That's impossible. Five wide receivers on third and three. Tanuvasa likes the drag to Custis. Custis has two defenders on him, but they're both on the wrong side of him to stop the 7 yard gain. Mo Neal, 4 yards out of the backfield, out of the heavy set.
Second down and six. Ball on the 23.
Mo Neal with another handoff. This time he gets the 6 yards he needs for the first down. It's first and 10 from the 15.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Tommy Tanuvasa again in the heavy set. Scrambling out. And Lofton for the touchdown.
By the power.
As promised, the return of He-Man.
Fringer became the mighty Battle Cat, and I became He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe. Only three others share this secret.
And turning the pick into points, Syracuse is now up 28-7 with 3:15 to go in the half. 14 points off of turnovers. A key part of this game.
See if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
And they make this. Akers gets 5 yards running out of the backfield into the flat when the third man takes him down.
Second down and five. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Quick slant to George Campbell on second and five. Gets eight and the first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
Akers breaks the first tackle, but is stopped by the second defender, who manages to keep him on the wrong side of the line of scrimmage. It's a zero-yard gain.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down.
Another handoff to Akers. It's a gain of one on second and ten. It's third and long now. The screen to the halfback is played excellently by the corner, the free safety, who manages to avoid the blocker, has to go around him in order to then make a tackle, a solo tackle in space to prevent Akers from gaining. Excellent defensive play as it forces FSU to punt. Schumacher gets 3 yards, and it's a minute 29 and two timeouts to go for the Syracuse Orange.
They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Offense just torched the defense through the air.
Orange rushing to the line with a low play clock.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, and you can guarantee
Metcalf out of the backfield pushes the defender over for 11 yards to get the first down. Moves the ball out of their own red zone and starts the clock moving. Shotgun Y trips now. Tanuvasa scrambles out. Lofton catches it and is hit, sandwiched between a defender and his friend in the wide receiving corps, and drops the ball. Stops the clock at 1:02 on their own 28. Five wide receivers now for Tommy Tanuvasa in the orange. Doesn't like his look. He scrambles out. He's got space. He's running downfield. And another late tackle out of bounds. Way out of bounds. But getting out does stop the clock. 4 yards from enemy territory and 55 seconds from halftime. Tanuvasa in the eye. Fakes the handoff. Throws to Lofton in space. Lofton looks upfield, sees a defender with the angle on him, and elects to get out of bounds. Stop the clock. That's a big 15-yard gain in only 5 seconds. To Metcalf, and a great job by Metcalf to bowl the defender over, pushing the ball over the first down marker, stops the clock for a few seconds while the refs move the chains, saving a little time for the Syracuse Orange as Tenevasa now scrambles out, gets shoestringed, and it's a gain of 1 yard, and they spend the timeout. Tenevasa under pressure as the Seminoles now looking for the play action. Throws an ugly check down. That stops the clock. It's 3rd and 9. 29 seconds on the 29-yard line. Tenevasa slides just past the marker. Calls the hurry up as the clock is about to resume after the first down. Tenevasa tries to sneak in a run. And the closing defender runs through the gap and stops him cold. Syracuse spend their last timeout. It's 2nd and 10 from the 20. And there are 20 seconds left in the half. Metcalf out of the backfield gets stopped short. It's 2nd and 2. Live clock under 10 seconds. And it's picked off by Fagan. One mistake to end the half with a pick to Fagan. Thankfully, he's stopped. No points are gained, but it takes a dent out of the momentum as we go into halftime.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. When we come to the studio, I like to give you a peek behind the curtain. I don't want to just give you scores and highlights and analysis. I want to let you know what happens in here. Pull it back, brother. You know how good these offenses were in the first half.
How good were these offenses?
So good, you were loving it. You have this big persona, big tough defensive guy. You were loving that offensive performance.
I don't know what you're talking about. I went to the snack room about 5 minutes into this game.
Not true.
It is fun. You do appreciate good offense. I mean, sometimes it's really bad defense, and then sometimes you see the designs of plays and the offensive coordinator dialing up perfect time to go long. Think about it. You get a few good positive runs. Everybody starts to commit. You take shots down the field. Sometimes the offenses do dial up great plays. Sometimes the defenses afford them that opportunity by dialing up bad plays. Right now, the OCs are on point.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, and now a quick look at our halftime stats for the game. Score is 28-7. Syracuse is leading. They also lead in first downs, 17-10, and total offense, 290 yards to 179. They've got 19 rushes for 122 yards and a touchdown to 10 for 8. Now, a number of Akers' early rushes went for 12 or 13 or 11 yards. The fact that he only have 8 means that quite the dent has been taken out of the offensive production by negative plays. Florida State actually leading 171 to 168 in passing yards, but it is 2 passing touchdowns to 1. Syracuse is 4 for 5 on third, whereas Florida State is 1 for 3. And the turnover battle is 2-1 with that pick to end the second quarter. Time of possession, about 2.5 minutes in Orange's favor. Tommy Tanuvasa, 13 for 16, 2 touchdowns and a pick for a 198 rating, versus DeAndre Francois, 12 for 16, 1 pick, 2 interceptions for a 160 rating. Cam Akers is 8 for 28 with a 3-yard average. He's got a long of 13. It's the zeros and the negatives that are hurting him. DeAndre Francois, a couple of big sacks for loss of yards there. On the ground, Tommy Tanuvasa, 10 for 71. That's a combination of about 2/3 scrambles to 1/3 reads. Mo Neal, 5 for 34, and Metcalf, 3 for 15. Lofton with 1 for 2 out of the triple option. All right, and receiving, Lofton is 5 for 89, Metcalf out of the backfield is 5 for 46, Custis primarily through the drag and one big passing play for 24 is 3 for 33. Seminole side of the ball, Campbell is 4 for 69, and Gavin is 2 for 38, Matthews 2 for 32, Akers 2 for 7 out of the backfield. On the defensive side, Thomas leads the Seminoles with 9 tackles and 1 tackle for loss, and Fagan, the strong safety, has the interception. Henderson Jr. has 4 tackles, 2 tackles for loss, and Green has 4 tackles, 3 tackles for loss, 2 of which are sacks. The interceptions are by Bailey for the 40-yard interception for points, and Foster for 9 yards. Nothing but touchdowns so far this game. 2 for Syracuse each quarter, Custis and Bailey and Tanuvasa and Lofton. 1 29-yard pass to Campbell by DeAndre Francois in the first quarter for the Seminoles. Thank you for joining us as we review these halftime stats. We will return in just a moment. And having elected to defer, Schumacher takes the knee in the end zone to begin the third quarter.
Second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Second and two, shotgun halfback weak. Keeper to Tanuvasa. He gets 7 yards and gets stood up.
So difficult to defend.
This is a perfect illustration of how to run the option, and it was perfect enough to get the first right there.
Injured player on the field. It's unclear who it is after the quarterback clearly wasn't it. Mo Neal, having gotten the fake, not the handoff, gets hit hard and is out for the game.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook.
Custis on the drag route catches the ball in the perfect gap between the zones, gets an 11-yard gain.
That's the right way to catch a pass.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49.
Not yet. The orange now just inside enemy territory. Metcalf, 5-yard gain. Metcalf with great vision, they call it 10 yards, but short of the first down mark. It's second and inches, every coach's favorite down and distance. Metcalf hit by the defender before he reached the line of scrimmage, but powers through for a 4-yard gain. First and 10, just outside the red zone.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Finally, we have the report. Mo Neal, minor concussion, out for the game. Custis, again, waiting till he's past the zone. Gets the catch and turns upfield for 7 this time. Now in the red zone for the orange.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Let's see if they can put that
shotgun normal halfback weak now. And Fagan jumps the route. That's his second pick of the game. as he sees the angle coming.
Son of a bitch! Give me a drink! Son of a bitch! This can't be me! Son of a bitch! If I can't get clean, I don't have drink, but I will. Yeah.
There's a strike complete. He's at midfield.
25-yard gain right after that pick by DJ Matthews. It is up to the Syracuse defense to stop that turnover from turning into points.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line.
Akers lined up behind. And the draw play gets burned by the guess. That's a big 3-yard loss. Slow down this drive. It's now 2nd and 13. And another screen, 6-yard loss this time as the defenders read the screen excellently and stay with the halfback. It's now third and long. Shotgun bunch. Champ Bailey dives to get a hand in on it. Makes the deflection, forces the punt, a huge defensive stand there from the orange after giving up the pick in the red zone. A solid punt goes out of bounds, looks like the 17. Tanuvasa scrambles, throws into space to Lofton. Lofton has to slow down to stay under the ball, and it means he gets tackled after the 24-yard gain.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 39. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Scrambling around. Steps out of bounds at the 42.
Tanuvasa doesn't like any of his options. He scrambles out of bounds after a 2-yard gain. But on first down, you can take that kind of loss.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Custis on the drag. This time he gets 2 as the man coverage follows with him, tackles him quickly. 3rd and 6 now for the orange, just shy of enemy territory. James Lofton leans back to get it, makes the catch, secures it to the ground, gets into enemy territory with a first down. Pitches out to Lofton. Corner closes and it's a 1-yard gain on the motion triple option right. Thank you. call it a zero-yard gain, but it's now 3rd and 10 for Tommy Campbell. The Orange are going to come out for a fourth down attempt here to put the game away. Tanuvasa under the center in a heavy set. A fantastic play by Lofton and Tanuvasa, who was closely covered. Pass on the run and hit immediately after. Waited as long as he could for Lofton to get space. That's a big play for the Orange. It's automatic, baby, and it feels good. And it feels so good. It feels good. And it feels so good. Metcalf is tackled forward for a 1 yard gain. It's now the fourth quarter. Third and 7 now from the 20. Tanuvasa scrambles, and he gets out of bounds. Just after the first down marker. Taking no risks about getting hit, running into safety and space. First and 10, ball on the 12. Shotgun split big. Metcalf out of the backfield. Uncovered this time, 7 yard gain. Spread flex now, and a handoff to Metcalf. 4 yards, and they call that inches. First and goal from the 1.
It's first down. First and goal here inside the 5 yard line.
Once again, spread flex. 4 down linemen, 2 of them tight on the center. Metcalf wide.
We've
upset. TCU drops the hammer and wins it big.
Well, that's an absolutely shocking upset. You can count on that one to turn the polls upside down when they're released. Syracuse is ready to kick it away.
Number 15 sets a return.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Syracuse defense has been a force to be reckoned with, especially this game.
Well, they have stepped up today. They just seem to be dialed into what this offense is trying to do. Good job against the run. They've been very physical. What I love is how relentless they run to the football.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here. But that being
Florida State down 35-7. Doesn't have a lot of time with Mitch to make difference as Matthews once again makes a productive slant. It's been one of the most productive passing routes for DeAndre Francois tonight, but he hasn't gone to it but four times.
From their own 45-yard line, first down.
It takes a number of people to stop Cam Akers from going for more than three, but the check down was forced by a heavy pass rush.
From their own 48-yard line, it's second down.
DeAndre Francois forced out of the pocket. He misses the first couple of defenders. He gets an 18-yard scramble.
From the 34-yard line, first down.
And there's the sack that Green's been looking for. Hasn't had one since the first quarter, I believe.
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. Another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Yeah. Hey, I'm gonna get to two. Another one bites the dust. Shoot up.
Akers gets 14 yards to make it third and three. 28-yard line, 4 minutes and 41 seconds. It is four down territory for Florida State.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
And the pass is incomplete, stopping the clock. And yes, the Seminoles are coming out. Five wide receivers on fourth and three.
There are five wide receivers split out, the quarterback in the gun. Pressure coming.
And with two missed tackles, DeAndre Francois gets into space and gets 23 yards on fourth and three. Miracle. Miracle fourth and three to get first and goal.
Play of this drive. They're crowding the line.
And that's a 2-yard loss on the handoff to Akers on first down.
And he's able to do that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 8. Defense stacked in tight here.
And he gets 2 yards back to where he was last play. Before the last play, I should say. Third and goal now. From the 5.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Pistol here. And it's a screen, sniffed out. It's a 1-yard gain by Akers. Probably going to force a fourth down attempt. Yes, looks like it. Fourth and goal from the 4. And Syracuse calls a timeout, not liking what they saw. And the sack forces the turnover.
They just couldn't pull it off.
Here I am. Rock you like a hurricane. Here I am. Rock you like a hurricane. Rock you like a hurricane.
Metcalf, 8 yards up the gut, second and 2 now, starts the clock moving. The Orange are on their own 16.
Second down and about 2 yards to go. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Metcalf, back-to-back carries, gets another 10 and a first down. James Lofton out in space, and there's a flag on the play. And they make it first and 12 from their own 24 because of clipping. Shotgun Y trips. Metcalf, 5-yard catch out of the backfield, make it 2nd and 7. Tommy Tanuvasa keeps it on the read option, gets it to 3rd and 2. On their own 34-yard line now.
So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers.
Tanuvasa scrambling. He stumbles.
Well, the stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over
He stumbles, and it causes him to not be able to get away from the defender, forcing a punt. Yep. Under a minute, and Syracuse Orange are taking all the time off the clock they can. Good punt by Hoffrichter, hits the ground, and bounces out at the 19.
And for Green, he's been making his presence felt.
Well, I think what we're seeing today from him is just raw athletic ability and great instincts. At one point, he's rushing the quarterback. The next thing you know, he's covering a tight end downfield. This kid has it all. To me, this is just a classic example of just being bigger, faster, and stronger than the guy trying to block him. I don't care if this offensive line uses two or even three guys to stop him. There's nothing they can do to stop this individual performance that he's putting on display.
And the screen goes for a loss. The Orange absolutely expecting it. Seminoles call a timeout to stop the clock at 29 seconds, 2nd and 14. Another tackle for loss. It's now 3rd and 4. Calls another timeout, 3rd and 14. Cordell Hudson with the deflection. And FSU elects to punt.
Schumacher is back to receive.
Schumacher catches it and gets a 7-yard return. Lofton, 19 yards, not out of bounds. The timeout is called by the Orange. They're on their own 36. Sorry, not the opponent's 36, I should say. Back five. 11 yards. This time he gets out of bounds. 6 seconds left on the clock on the 24-yard line. Come out, 5 wide receivers.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers.
Lofton, they take a shot at the end zone. They don't get there. It's 1st and goal now from the 4. They get one attempt to either go for the end zone or attempt the field goal. They put the field goal unit on the field for the guaranteed points. Couple of big upsets you're seeing there. You didn't see one this game, as the Orange came out with a excellent first quarter and first half of the second half. They gave up a pick to end the first half, and they gave up a pick to begin the third quarter. Ultimately, these didn't deal enough damage them to lose the game, as they had gotten out to a blazing start. Big play of the game there, as you're watching it, the defensive touchdown by Champ Bailey. Jumps the check down and runs it in for the score. Yep. Thank you for joining us for this first half of our doubleheader. We will be resuming shortly with Tulsa at Navy. .512 total offense to .258, 192-34 in rushing, 320-224 in passing. Third down conversion, only 14%, 1 out of 7 for the Seminoles was key, as was the early turnovers that put the momentum in Syracuse's favor, enough for them to get a lead that the Orange couldn't come back from. Sorry, I should say the Seminoles couldn't come back. You see 13 tackle for loss right there. Thank you for joining us. We'll be back shortly. super mute is off.
Hello, once again, sports fans. We've got the second game of our doubleheader coming up here in just a minute. It's Chad President, Mr. President, a 96 quarterback, leading Tulsa against Navy at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. This is a game that should settle some positioning in the American Conference, could give one of the teams an inside track to a good bowl game. It is a game not without value. Without any further ado, we're going to pass the headset over to Coach Ninja, who will give you the insight on Tulsa's depth chart and what you might be able to expect from the Golden Hurricanes.
Chad President, 96 overall, 92 awareness, is a very good quarterback with 88 speed, 94 agility, 94 acceleration. We expect him to run. Looks like he's got 15-2 passing to interception and 286 yards a game through the air. And only 38 yards on the ground, but an excellent yards after the first hit. Especially because his yards after the first hit is more than his total yards. I have to believe they're taking sacks out of that number. All right. And 91 halfback, impact player, gets 29 yards a game on the ground. They must be throwing to him. Yes, 40 yards a game, including a 67-yard pass. So he's an impact player because they pass to him, not because they run through him. They've got a fullback who is good. Keenan Johnson is injured. Josh Stewart, 50 yards a game. Avery Gregg, 78 yards a game. Stokes, 47 yards a game. Anderson and Santana. Yeah, they're running four wide, and it looks like, 77 yards a game. Johnson is a recent injury. 71 tight end Love, 40 yards a game. They throw to him more than they should, apparently. All right, the line is 83, 70, 80, 84, 81. Not the strongest of lines. There's deficiencies there, and where the biggest gap is at 70, there's not a lot of help. On the defensive side of the ball, they have 77 left end and an 87 right end impact player, so that's a lot better on the right than they are on the left there. 87 tackle backed up by an 80 tackle. They probably only run a three-man front. Impact player, left outside linebacker, 84, is good. Cooper Edmondson is out. He's the big injury. He is replaced by Zaven Collins, the 73 right outside linebacker. That's a significant injury. Revels, right outside linebacker, is 80. So that's, two decent linebackers, but a big loss there. Reggie Robinson, number 9, is by far their best corner, although Wadley and Evans aren't too shabby. Free safety, 77, strong safety, 84, and a hot streak, so this puts them, they are hot and cold in the secondary, just like they are hot and cold in really all sectors of the defense. They've got really one guy in each sector who's quite good, even still after the injury, other ones that are middling and other ones that are weak. So this is a game about containing the president. 77 and 83 are decent legs, so field position won't be great, but won't be terrible, probably. They're a team overall that's given up two picks so far this season, but they've got a lot of good stats, excellent passing offense, number 4 in the country. We'll see what, if anything, we can do about that. Without further ado, I'll turn it over to Coach Spectre, give you the play-by-play for this game.
We're We're expecting a good matchup here. This was the game that went down to the wire last year. Navy kicking a field goal at the death to win by 3 in Oklahoma. But this year, they get them at home in Annapolis. Chad President, the star player, the leader of the Tulsa offense, a big reason why they have a 91 overall offense. Navy at home, sporting the white socks and white shoes. They want to get clear vision as to whether or not the foot's in bounds. 88 Tulsa versus an 86 Navy. Two teams that went head-to-head last year and the year before, both in close run affairs. I believe 2 years ago was a double overtime win by Navy at home. This is a game that has not been settled by more than 3 points. Tulsa coming into the affair with the fourth-ranked passing attack and the 120th-ranked rushing attack. You can expect them to be led by President, throwing the ball 80% of the time, possibly more. On defense, the Golden Hurricanes are 31st in the nation in points per game allowed. Meanwhile, Navy, with the 7th-ranked rushing defense, that won't necessarily be tested today. It will be the 113th-ranked passing defense that will come under fire from the Golden Hurricanes. Offensively, Navy, with the 36th-ranked rushing attack, they're going to hope to keep Tulsa off the field with a ball control, turnover-free offense. Some recruits visiting Annapolis this week. Navy with some targets on their mind if the game goes their way. Chad President, as expected, the best player for Tulsa, with Taylor II, a 91, and Edmondson, the middle linebacker, injured. Big hit. Major loss for the Tulsa defense, the 90 overall middle linebacker. That should allow Navy to matriculate the ball down the field, mistakes notwithstanding. We welcome you to Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, where placards ring the field, memorializing some of the greatest victories from the United States Naval Forces and Marine Forces, some of the greatest battles by the United States military, some great victories and memorials to fallen troops. It's a special and unique sacrifice that these young men make. Rigorous academic standards and an expectation of 4 years of military service. Every coach preparing to face the midshipmen must warn his lineup to play with valor, to play with honor. Navy will kick off. They'll receive the second half kickoff, and we are underway here from Annapolis. Chad President, 10 out of 11 the previous game, possibly injured for part of it, but coming in well-tuned. Four wide receivers and a single back set for Tulsa with their pass-heavy offense. Navy responding with a spy defense, trying to counteract the scrambling of Chad President. It's a completion on a curl route and a broken tackle by Greg. He picks up an extra 15 yards after the catch. It's going to be a 28-yard gain to get this game kicked off. Already Tulsa into Navy territory at the 46-yard line of the midshipman. Over pursuit by the Navy defense allows the halfback Taylor the second, a 31-yard gain. He's down inside the 20. And immediately, Tulsa threatens. League One, of course, does play on the toughest sliders available. It's Jared's block set from Operation Sports. Completion to the extremities. Avery Gregg picks up 8. It's going to be second and short for the Golden Hurricanes. .335 bear for the midshipmen. They react to the option. The pylon's still in the field of play following the hurry-up offense. And once again, the Golden Hurricanes go no huddle and Navy trying to respond. President ditches it to the outside to Taylor the second. He picks up the score. And just like that on the opening drive, the most difficult drive to stop, Tulsa off to an early 6-0 lead. .32 seconds into the ball game. Tulsa opens the scoring on their first drive, and Navy now with their chance to respond.
Another move up in the poll. It felt as if the game rested on every play.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. What a collision!
Up the middle goes Walker. He picks up 24 on the return. Going to give Navy possession on their own 21. Coach Ninja making some adjustments in the formation subs that are available to you with the right stick in the huddle. Taking advantage of a few extra seconds here on this opening salvo. It's the shotgun with 5 receivers out there. It's the middle slant facing off against a dime 3-2-6. Coverage on the drag route, and Coach Ninja astutely throws to the slant to pick up 10 and the first down of the ball game for Navy. Double checking some details, Coach Ninja takes a look at the formations. Now we're set for the second series of downs for the midshipmen. It's a 3-3-5 bear for Tulsa facing off against Abe running the flex bone. Man in motion left to right across your radio dial. Abe on the keeper picks up 4. It's going to be 2nd and 6, outside the 30, well outside the 30 now, to the 36-yard line. Going to be 2nd and 6 when we resume play.
Second and 6, ball on the 36.
Navy coming out in the flex bone, AB commandeering the offense. Check that, it's the eye tight. AB throwing left to right across your radio dial to the backup tight end, Zach Frade. He picks up another first down. It's a 7-yard gain, and Navy already out to the 43. Shotgun wide trips now for the midshipmen facing off against a 3-3-5 stack by Tulsa. Zach Abe back to pass, looking, finds the halfback out of the backfield. Perry picks up 9 yards, 2 feet and 3 inches. It's only a matter of inches for another midshipman first down as they breach Tulsa territory across the 50. Looks like the ball is going to be spotted at about the 47. Every coach's favorite down and distance, second and short. Navy coming out of the huddle. Twin tight end set. It's an eye tight. 3-3-5 stack for the Golden Hurricane. Navy content to give their team a rest. They'll hike it late. Hand off up the gut, and it's good for the first down. There's a flag on the play. Looks like it might be a face mask. It is indeed. That's an extra 15 yards for the midshipman. They'll gladly take it down to Tulsa's 29-yard line. It's the eye tight once again. Two tight ends for the midshipman. 3-3-5 stack once again for Tulsa. Once again, content to give a rest. The give up the gut results in three. Now going to be second and seven. Inside Tulsa's 30-yard line. Down to the 27. Important second and seven here in the early going for the midshipmen. Ball on the 27. Looks like a 3-3-5 under. Facing off against the shotgun wide trips. No, that looks like a shotgun normal. Single back set, 11 personnel for Navy. It's an angle route, and Perry is wide open. Room to run, takes it down to the 11-yard line. It's a 14-yard gain. That's his second catch of the game for 24 yards. They'll mark it at the 13. Navy taking over on first and 10. An opportunity to get a first down inside the five. This time it's the shotgun wide trips. Navy surveying the defense. Hand off up the gut to Perry. He picks up good yardage. It's a 9-yard gain. Going to be second and just one. Navy with plenty of options here, but little space to work with. Eye tight, twin tight end set for the midshipman facing off against the 3-3-5 Bear. Milking the clock, Navy gets the first down on a 3-yard gain by Malcolm Perry. It's going to be first and goal. Looks like about the 1-yard line plus 3 or 4 inches. We've got about 2.5 minutes remaining here in the first frame. Navy on their first possession, looking to equal the success of Tulsa's first drive.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
The home checkered end zone awaits as Navy lines up in the eye tight. Perry on the give, up the gut, met by multiple defenders. It's a stop for no gain. Now going to be second and goal. Not too much to go.
From the 2-yard line.
6 feet away from glory, the ball resting in the shadow of Navy's own goalposts. Read option is the call. It's a give up the gut. He picks up half the distance to the goal line. It's a 1-yard gain by Malcolm Perry. Now going to be third and goal from exactly 1 yard out. Multiple receivers coming out on third down. 3-4 defense for Tulsa. Back to pass goes Avey. Finds his man in the end zone, and we are tied up, awaiting the extra point. Seconds of the first frame find us in a tie ball game as the midshipmen kick off to Tulsa. It's halfway into the end zone and they take a knee. They'll start with the ball at their own 25. One minute remaining in the first quarter. It's 7-7 between these two foes. Navy bringing pressure, unable to get there, and the slant route successful for 11 yards. Avery Gregg picks up his third catch of the game for 47 yards. No huddle attack now, forces Navy to stay in their set. Another slant route successful. That's a good call against this defensive setup, and back-to-back plays in the no-huddle set, forcing Navy into an unsatisfactory defense given the play calls. We'll see if they can generate some pressure. They can't. It's out to the edge. It's short of the first down this time as Jerrion Anderson picks up 7 on the edge. Spread set for Tulsa. A dump off to Stokes. He picks up 9. Keelon Stokes with his first catch. No huddle once again. Tulsa playing aggressive on offense. Navy audibles out of the blitz. And the corner route, usually successful. This time, a half a yard out of bounds works in Navy's favor. It's going to give their defense an opportunity to rest here facing second down.
From the 36-yard line, it's second down.
Navy coming out in the 3-3-5. Tulsa with a single back set, 11 personnel. Corner on the blitz, he's picked up, and the pass over the middle complete. It's the first down and a couple of more. Jerrion Anderson, his second catch of the game, going to put Tulsa just outside the red zone. Back to pass goes Chad President, tries to scramble, can't get away from the pressure, and Navy gets their first sack of the ball game. Seven all, seven up, you might say, at the end of the first quarter. Both offenses successful on their opening drives. Now Tulsa driving, however, facing a second and long deep inside Navy territory. They'll call it second and 13. We see Tulsa lining up 4 wide receivers coming out of the huddle. Navy going with a 4-2-5 against this 4 wide receiver set. It's a draw play, and the defense is there all over it. Corey Taylor II dropped for a loss. Another three-yard loss. Now going to bring up third and long. It's the 3-3-5 across. That's what Coach Ninja selects. Cover four. We'll see. Forced by the pressure to dump it off to Avery Gregg for just five. Fourth and 12 is going to bring out the kicking unit for Tulsa. As the Navy defense keeps Tulsa out of the end zone on their second drive. Just a few seconds here into the second quarter. As Tulsa lining up for the field goal. Kick is up, and it's wide left by a little bit. That 79 kicker unable to get the ball between the pipes. It's a missed field goal, and that is a win for the Navy defense. They'll now take over. 7.5 minutes remaining in the second quarter. In a tie ball game, in a situation where they will receive the second half kickoff. Flexbone Hayes comes out to run it. He's tackled for a loss. It's going to be a 1 yard loss, not going to be second and 11, as Navy hopes to get themselves to third and approachable. Backed up inside their 30 at the 25-yard line. Navy would like nothing more than to convert here. It's the eye tight with two tight ends. Looks to be a slightly different look from the midshipman. And in the zone, in between the fragments of the zone, in tight coverage, with three defenders nearby, the midshipmen have faith in tight end Amir Lee. He picks up the catch, hangs onto it, and it's a key first down as Navy now out to the 40-yard line. First down. 6.5 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Three-three-five bear against this eye tight. And Perry picks up one. Going to be second and 9. Just outside Navy's 40-yard line. Ball resting at the 41. 10 yards from Tulsa territory. 3-3-5 stack now for Tulsa. Facing off against the shotgun, Y trips. AB in the shotgun. Takes the snap, back to pass, looking. Finds Amir Lee for his second key catch. He's got 2 for 24, both of them having been important. This time it's 8 yards. That's going to set Navy up with a third and just one to keep this drive alive. Should have seen that sooner, but I relegated him.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Third and one. Five and change remaining in the first half. Five receivers out for the midshipmen. AB back to pass, surveys the field. The receiver stumbles, but gets open by a half a step. However, the contact was a little bit too quick. He's unable to hang on to the ball. Now going to be a key fourth and one near midfield. As you know, if you follow League One, you're allowed 12 fourth down attempts throughout the regular season. Fourth downs are regulated, but it appears that Navy may roll the dice here, trying to get some early momentum. Big fourth down coming here. Navy in the shotgun set, looks, and it's complete despite close coverage. Taylor Jackson hangs on, and that's going to be another midshipman first down. Gets 6 yards each foot on this one. Second 11 now. Navy just inside their own territory. Looks like, no, it's just inside Tulsa territory at about the 49-yard line. Single back set, 11 personnel for the midshipmen. 3-3-5 over for Tulsa. Out of the backfield, wide open on the angle, and Malcolm Perry picks up a big 9-yard gain. That's going to make it 3rd and 2. Navy goes no huddle. Content to let the seconds melt off the clock. We'll see what happens here. Quarterback keeper, he gets the first down. Zach Abey with a 5-yard, check that, we'll call it 6-yard gain. And with exactly 3 minutes, Navy with another conversion, continuing to matriculate the ball down the field. Now resting just outside scoring range at Tulsa's 33.5-yard line. 2:46 and counting. Hand off up the gut to Perry. He's got a decent hole. Picks up 4 on the carry. And with 2.5 minutes left, it's 2nd and 6 as the midshipmen go back to the no huddle. Avey heated up, finds Perry out of the backfield. He breaks a tackle and is tackled by the second man, but not before he gets the first down. And with 2:11 remaining in the first half, Navy has the ball at the 24-yard line of the Golden Hurricane. 3-3-5 once again for Tulsa. Twin tight end set once again for Navy. Back to pass goes Avey off the play action. Heavy rush sacks him for a loss. And we'll see if Navy calls a timeout. They do indeed. 1:44 remaining. 2nd and 16 at the 30. You imagine this might be at the edge of their field goal range. If they can avoid a turnover, they could get points off of this drive. But boy, would they like to get more than 3. Second and long now, 3-3-5 stack for Tulsa. Shotgun wire trips for the midshipman. Abey in the shotgun set. takes the snap, looking, and it's intercepted by Mays inside the 20. He breaks the tackle, takes it out to about the 24-yard line. It's the first turnover of the ball game here in this 7-7 slugfest. Tulsa is going to take over with less than 2 minutes remaining. You expect to see their two-minute drill led by Chad President. Navy in the quarter defense. The receiver makes the catch, picks up 8. Keelon Stokes with his second catch of the ballgame. Now going to be 2nd and 2 from Tulsa's 32. Navy, as we said at the beginning, will receive the second half kickoff. If they can prevent Tulsa from scoring after the turnover, we would count that as a win. Villalobos upended. Can't quite get there, but it's an interception by Williams. He breaks the tackle. He's down inside the 15 to the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Navy, on the turnover. And that is a huge turnover by the Navy defense. Massive play by Williams and the Navy defense in this tight football game. At the end of this affair, we may look back on that as potentially the play of the game. Having thrown a pick of their own, being in a deficit of momentum, and facing off against a hot offense who had scored on their previous drive, if you're a Midshipman fan, boy, did they need that.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
We'll see if the Navy defense is heated up off of that. Tulsa now playing aggressive in the two-minute drill in the shotgun set. President back to pass, finds a man, picks up the first down. We'll see if they mark him out of bounds. I'm not sure if he made it to the sideline or not. They're going to run no huddle regardless with a minute and 18 remaining. Looks like he did get out of bounds. Tulsa with a play action, it looks like a draw play. And they'll spend their first time out after that play was marginally successful for just 3 yards. Navy content to give up a few more of those as the aggressive Tulsa offense with only 7 points here in the first half. Back to pass goes President, finds a man on the out route. He picks up 7 yards, but it is short of the first down, going to be 3rd and inches. And inside of 2 minutes, that presents a curious question.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not.
Looks like we're going to get a replay on this. It's rarely overturned. And it looks like his toes might have been still down when he made the catch. My suspicion is they'll count that one. It does indeed stand. No cost to anyone regarding timeouts. Simply an excuse to take a look at some graphics. However, the ball near midfield, out at Tulsa's 46-yard line, and with 2 timeouts and an aggressive offensive game plan, the Golden Hurricanes still a threat to put some points on the board here before the break. Shotgun single back set. It's an option play, and President on the keeper picks up the first down and a few more. He breaks the tackle to do so, but he gets 11 into Navy territory. As expected, a no-huddle attack now from the Golden Hurricane. With two timeouts, trailing by 7, the ball now resting at Navy's 43. President back to pass, finds a man on the sideline, picks up 9 yards. Now going to be 2nd and 1 with exactly 1 minute remaining. The clock will stop with the receiver getting out of bounds.
It's 2nd down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
2nd and 1, 1 minute remaining. It's a pass play by Tulsa, and again to the sideline they go on an out route. It's an 8-yard gain by Keelon Stokes. That's going to be a 1st and 10 at the Navy 27. Tulsa threatening to make this a ball game as we enter the break. With two timeouts at the 27-yard line, with spikes available, Tulsa with a fair amount of time left. I don't imagine they'll be able to run the ball from here to the break. President back to pass, hits Greg. He picks up the 1st down and a few more. Down to the 9.5-yard line. They'll call it 1st and 10 from the 10. The 2nd timeout by Tulsa.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Three, 3-3-5 by Navy. Tulsa completes it. It's inside the 5. The clock will move. 41 and counting. Interception by Haley. Huge play by the Navy defense. The 2nd turnover, and both of them have been massive. That's going to prevent Tulsa from getting any points, and it actually provides Navy with an opportunity to try to steal a field goal. They've got 2 timeouts and 29 seconds.
First and 10, ball on the 19.
Five wide set, Navy with all the momentum. Back to pass goes Abey, looking, scrambles to the left, chucks it deep. There's an incompletion. It only costs 5 seconds. It does not cost a timeout, and Navy can reset. Still with 2 timeouts, they have all options available. They can throw over the middle. They can spike the ball if it's beyond the 1st down. They can call a timeout if they do so choose. Abey back to pass, looking, scrambles to his left, has some room, gets the 1st down, and Navy calls a timeout. And with 17 seconds at their own 30, Navy needs some yardage. Twin tight end set for the midshipman. It's a fake handoff, and it's a sack, and that's probably going to end the half. Navy's defense withstanding pressure from Tulsa, and once again coming up with a 2nd turnover, a key turnover. Navy winning the turnover battle and leading the game.
So we've played 2 quarters. The midshipmen lead 14-7.
We
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
The Golden Hurricanes start down at the half, but in a game like this, not really that big a deal. Everything has been so tight, the importance of every play magnified, especially when we get to the second half and coming down the stretch.
No doubt, Reese. And as a player, you knew this was coming. And so what do? You make sure that you hydrate the day before. You make sure leading up to it, you've been straight swole in the weight room. You make sure that you watched film all week and you prepared for this moment, because now it's time. It's arrived. It's time for you to come up, step up in the second half, make a big play. You knew this was a really good team you were going up against. You knew that it was going to come down to a late last-second play. Can you make it? Can you be the one to come away with the heroic play? Or are you going to be the one to come away with nothing?
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
We now open our second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He sends this one deep. And it goes.
13-yard gain, and Navy continues to keep Tulsa guessing. Good start to the drive. Navy lining up in the eye tight. Content to let the seconds melt off the clock with the lead, keeping that Tulsa offense off the field. Up the gut goes Perry. He picks up one, going to be second and nine. We're 33, 38, 39, and more seconds into the second half. Navy with the football and the lead. Out to their own 39. It's a key, second and nine now. AB now well heated up. Navy content to control the flow of the game. Complete out of the backfield to Perry. He picks up the first down and more. It's a 13-yard gain to Malcolm Perry. He's got 8 catches for 66 yards, a focal point of the Navy offense with great success so far.
10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Navy once again with the hurry-up-and-wait offense. Six and a half and counting. Back to pass goes AB. It's intercepted on the flat by Bunch. Missed tackle, and he's going to take it the distance. This is going to be a tie ball game. Navy is going to equal the turnovers at 2 apiece. The score is about to be equal, but Navy will get the football back.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that
3-man front for Tulsa as Navy takes over once again on offense. Good pass on the drag route, and Jackson picks up 5.5. That's a good start to the drive. Second and five now from Navy's 30-yard line. They have the ball here in a tie ball game. Looks like it's a read option facing off against the 3-3-5. And AB on the keeper picks up the first down and a few more. It's a 10-yard gain on second and five. That's going to set up Navy with a first and 10 on their own 39-yard line. The midshipmen still in control of the ball game, possessing the football, trying to take the lead. Eye tight set up the middle goes Perry. He picks up 2.5. They're going to call it second and 8.
That makes it second and 8. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on their own 41.
The ball now out to the 41-yard line of the midshipman. They can see the logo clear as day. Complete to Lee. He's wide open. He's got 8 yards of space. He picks up extra yards after the catch. It's a big play for the Navy offense. That's going to put them well into Tulsa territory. The ball now resting at Tulsa's 22. Navy halfway through the third quarter with the ball in a tie ball game. Fakes the give and Hayes on the keeper. Fumbles the ball. It's picked up off the ground by Tulsa. We will await the replay to see if he may have been down. It is a official's challenge, which usually favors the offense. His knee looks like it might have been down. Looks like a false sense of security for Tulsa. There's the knee. Then the ball comes out. After review of the play, the it is reversed indeed. That's a major call in Navy's favor here in this tie ball game with the ball deep in Tulsa territory. Now, second and three from the 16. My guess is that Hayes or AB won't get a carry on this play. AB in the backfield, 11 personnel, 3-3-5 defense for Tulsa. Second and three, Navy with the football. It's the give to Perry. He picks up the first down, and it's a fresh set of downs. Here late in the third quarter, Navy driving. The brief scare on the giveaway that was overturned by official review. And Navy maintains possession and momentum. AB heated up. Complete over the middle on the drag to Jackson. He's got a 6 yard gain. He's got four important catches for 14 yards and a touchdown. This one gives Navy second and four on the six. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Three defense with some machinations by Tulsa prior to the snap. Navy content to give their offense a rest. It's a give up the middle. It's a first and goal for the midshipmen. There's 2 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. Navy with all sorts of options. The ball resting 6 feet from the goal line. The seconds ticking off of the third quarter. Still, their opening drive of the second half, Tulsa's offense has yet to have the ball here in the second half. Three-three-five bear for the Golden Hurricane. Twin tight ends set for Navy. The give up the gut. He stumbles, and it's going to cost him the touchdown. He gets a yard, but it's only second and goal for the midshipmen, still with plenty of options.
brings up a second and goal. About a yard to Pater.
Twin tight end set for the midshipman. The ball resting inches from glory. The seconds melting. The give to the fullback, and he's into the paint. Anthony Garagiolo picks up 6 points, and Navy leads. Navy kicks off deep into the end zone, and in those checkerboards, Tulsa elects to kneel. They're going to take over the football. With seconds remaining here in the third quarter, we are quickly approaching the fourth quarter, and Navy leads.
I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Chad President brings out the Tulsa offense. Multiple wide receivers with a single back set. Goes back to pass, scrambles, gets out to the right side, gets almost near the first down. Going to be a 9-yard gain, second and one, and Tulsa goes to the no huddle. Seconds and counting. Handoff up the gut. He gets the first down and a couple of more.
What the shit, guys?
Breaks the tackle, and he is off to the races inside the 30, inside the 20. Breaks another tackle and falls forward at the 16-yard line. Could have been a 3-yard gain, turns into about a 35-yard gain. 21 seconds left here in the third. Back to pass goes President. Finds a man on the extremities. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 5.5-yard line. Going to be first and goal. Navy trying to respond here in the no-huddle attack. It's a handoff up the gut. A broken tackle leads to a touchdown, and we've got a tie ball game awaiting the extra point here with just seconds remaining in the third quarter. However, Navy about to receive the kickoff.
He's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 10. They'll bring him down at the 18. Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make the play could win this game.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all
21-21, 8 seconds remaining in the third. It's a read option. A.B. on the keeper has some space, picks up some blocks. And on the final play of the third quarter, Navy picks up 12, 13 yards. Now out to their 32-yard line to begin the fourth quarter. Looks like a dime 3-2-6 for Tulsa, facing off against this twin tight end set. The give to Perry, up the gut, he picks up 2.5. Going to be second to Holiday. Might be second to 7 and a few.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 34.
Three, 3-3-5 stack for Tulsa facing off against this shotgun wide trips. We've got a tight contest here. 7 and change remaining in the football game. Out of the backfield to Perry. He picks up the first down and a couple of more. It's a 9-yard gain. And with 7:13, Navy has a first down. We'll see if they mark him out of bounds. They might not. That would get the, and indeed, the clock does move.
From their own 43-yard line, it's first down.
Shotgun wide trips against a 3-3-5 stack. The handoff up the gut to Perry. He picks up decent yardage. They'll call it 4. It's going to be 2nd and 6. Shotgun normal. We've got 3 wide receivers, 1 tight end, and a halfback. That is 11 personnel, folks. Facing off against a dime 3-2-6. Back to pass goes AB. Finds Perry. Wide open once again. Over the middle. Picks up 9 and a Navy first down. We now cross the 6-minute threshold. Navy with the football at Tulsa's 44.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 44.
We see the first downs there, 20-13 in favor of the midshipmen. Hand off up the gut to Perry. He's got some blocking. Picks up 5 on first down. Now going to be 2nd and 5. And the clock continues to melt away. 5:20 now. Navy at Tulsa's 39.
From the 39-yard line, it's 2nd down.
Shotgun normal. Single back set. 4 down the node. That looks like a 3-3-5 over. And Navy has just the right response for it. It's a 5-yard gain and another midshipman first down. That clock will move shortly. Navy with the football at the Tulsa 33. Three, 3-3-5 for Tulsa. Navy with a shotgun normal. It's a read option. The defense bites on the halfback. That gives AB the first down and a 13-yard gain. And now Navy in complete control at the Tulsa 20-yard line. We're in a tie ball game. A field goal would take the lead. But you know that Coach Ninja and the Navy midshipmen would like nothing more than to take more time off the clock and score a touchdown. We're more than halfway through the fourth quarter at the snap of the ball.
10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Less than 4 minutes remaining. To give up the gut to Perry. He's got good blocking. It's an excellent first down play for 7 yards. Going to set up Navy with second and just 3 as the clock continues to move.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first.
3.5 remaining. To give up the gut to Perry. He's got good blocking. Picks up the first down perfectly. The clock will stop momentarily, but we'll move at the spot of the ball. Navy with an opportunity to get one more first down if they could potentially get the ball to the half-yard line.
Here's the 11th play of the drive.
Tick, tick, tick. Go the seconds.
Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Read option, AB on the keeper, blockers, pancaking defenders, and Navy in excellent position, 2nd and 4 from the 4.5, and it'll be less than 2 minutes when the ball is snapped. Twin tight end set. Looks like a read option against a 3-3-5. It's a give up the gut, and he's stopped just short. It's a 3rd and 1, but if you're a Navy fan, not a bad position. More time off the clock. Navy with an opportunity here to hike it with just a minute and change late in the football game. It's a give up the gut. It's a quarterback keeper. And that is a touchdown for Navy. They take the lead with just 1:16 remaining. The midshipmen kickoff, leading by 7 late in the football game. Just 76 seconds remaining. Chad President, 16 out of 19. Only one incompletion. He's got 2 interceptions and 16 completions on 19 attempts. High risk reward for the Tulsa offense in the passing game thus far today. Their backs are against the wall now. Navy with the lead. Quick pass. It will take some time off the clock. It's short of the first down. Tulsa's going to have to go no huddle. 64 seconds and counting. Back to pass goes President. He scrambles, tries to get the first. He will get the first. And it's a timeout by Tulsa. 56 seconds remaining. The ball resting at the 37-yard line.
First down. That's a nice job.
Five wide receivers now. Spread set as Tulsa rolls the dice. President backs to pass, finds a man, barely complete, breaks the tackle, gets the first down. Another timeout by the Golden Hurricane as he was unable to get out of bounds. That'll stop the clock with 49 seconds. Tulsa near midfield.
First and 10. Ball on the 49.
3-3-5 across for Navy. President to the sideline. It's going to be short, and Tulsa's going to go no huddle. We're inside 40 seconds remaining in the football game. Second and one, but the down and distance doesn't matter. It's going to be a spike here, looks like, for Tulsa. That'll stop the clock with 31 seconds remaining. It's third and one. You got to imagine that the Golden Hurricanes will go for it on fourth down. Navy looking to see what they might call on defense. What would you call? It's the 3-3-5 across cover four. It's a screen pass. It's going to be the first down. Picks up a block, and once again, Tulsa's going to have to go no huddle. They've only got 24 seconds remaining and only one timeout. They're going to wait as long as possible to use that timeout. It doesn't look like a spike. It looks like a regular play. Let's see what happens. Back to pass goes President. Finds a man near the sideline, picks up the first down, and there's a flag on the play. He's short of the first down. It's a roughing the passer. That's going to stop the clock. That's going to stop the clock and put the ball at the 13-yard line. And with 16 seconds left, Tulsa has first and 10 from the 13. Navy's defensive line a little bit tired. They're going to try to get every second of rest here in the huddle.
From the 13-yard line.
16 seconds remaining in regulation. 7-point ball game. Back to pass goes President. Has to scramble. Doesn't have a man. Picks up a block. And it's a touchdown with a flag. It might be a face mask. We'll see what it is. It is indeed a face mask. That's going to be a touchdown for Tulsa, and awaiting the extra point, we have a tie ball game with 9 seconds remaining on the clock. These two teams have faced off twice before. Both have been extremely close games. It looks like this one is going to need extra time to settle it. With just 9 seconds left, Navy hoping for a return for a touchdown or a Hail Mary. And with 5 seconds left, Navy could possibly get 20 yards in 3 or 4 seconds, but I expect they'll go for the whole kit and caboodle.
Late in the fourth quarter now, game is tied. Which coach can outcoach the other? It's a chess match right now. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts.
It's a sack. That's going to end regulation, and we will go to overtime.
Well, we've had fun, folks, but-
But we're not done yet because this game is heading to overtime.
Chad President, the star quarterback for Tulsa, refusing to quit on the two-minute drill. Ties this ball game up. Navy will bat in the bottom of the inning. Tulsa will take over. The midshipmen hoping to hold them to three. Complete to the outside, a broken tackle into the five and downed. He is not in the paint and Tulsa is not in yet. They do, however, go to the no huddle. It's an option play, and it's a touchdown for Tulsa on the opening salvo of overtime. Navy now knows what they need, therefore giving them four downs to work with.
And he adds the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
In the Big Easy, Tulane taking the field in New Orleans.
Going to be first and 10 from the 25. For the midshipmen, neither team spending their single timeout. We're in the first frame of overtime. A turnover would end it, but a touchdown extends the game. It's a give up the gut, it's a good game. The call at two might have been 2.5. Second and 8 now for the midshipmen. They'll go no huddle, trying to take Tulsa off guard. Complete on the drag route. That's going to bring up third and 2. Navy with two opportunities to get 6 feet.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
3-3-5 stack for Tulsa. Shotgun halfback weak for the midshipmen. Read option to the left side. It's a give to the halfback. Perry picks up the first down, and many more are going to be first and goal from the 5. No clock involved here, folks. Navy trailing by a second in the first inning of overtime.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
To give up the gut. And it's a touchdown for the midshipmen. Extra point is up and good. We now go to double overtime. This time, Navy will take the field first.
Take another round at least. You can bet the coaches are going to look to be more aggressive.
Going to put them under pressure should they receive a fourth down situation. Ball rests at the 25-yard line as the midshipmen take over. Read option out of the wide trips. Give to the halfback. Perry picks up 2.5. They'll call it 2nd and 8. The clock not a factor as we're in the second frame of overtime. Navy batting in the top of the inning.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 23.
Shotgun wide trips for the midshipmen. Tulsa creeping on the line of scrimmage. Back to pass, hits the angle route, and Perry once again picks up big yardage. Going to be 1st and goal from the 7. First down from the 7-yard line. The midshipmen take the field. Read option by the middies. Quarterback keeper by AB. Inside the 5, into the paint. And just like that, Navy takes the lead. Now in the bottom of the 2nd overtime, Tulsa takes over. We could potentially see another no-huddle attack by the Golden Hurricane. They've enjoyed that for most of the football game. Heavy pressure, and it's almost intercepted. It's going to be a deflection in the end zone. But that's a good play for the midshipmen. It brings up 2nd and 10. They'll give their defense a rest. Take all the time in the world to call the play.
From the 25-yard line, it's 2nd down.
2nd and 10 now for Tulsa. Screen pass by Tulsa out to the left side. A broken tackle, stumbles forward for the 1st down. Going to be 1st and 10 from the 10.5. Out to the flat, tackled for a gain of 3. Now 2nd and 7. Interesting play upcoming. Navy playing aggressive. They've got the 4-3 out there against a spread set. They'd like nothing more than to create pressure on Chad President. It's a draw play, and the aggressive defense pays off. It's now 3rd and 7. And Navy with the opportunity to call the play they want on 3rd down.
It's 3rd down and 7 yards to go.
Midshipman coming out in a dime normal. Looks like a cover 2 man. President looking, scrambles. And it's a touchdown for Tulsa. Chad President takes the hit and could potentially be a little bit tired in the top of the third. We go now to the third overtime period. Tulsa will get us started. Neither team having used their timeout yet. We'll see if Navy elects to use their timeout strategically. If they'd like to get the right personnel on a third down play, they could hold Tulsa to a field goal, and a touchdown would win it. Screen pass by Tulsa. Navy defense ready for it this time. It's a tackle for loss, 2 yards in the backfield, 6 feet further back, and now at the 27-yard line, Tulsa facing a pressure situation. Four wide receivers and a halfback in the huddle for the Golden Hurricane. Navy responding with the quarter. Second and 12 from the 27. Third overtime is where we sit. Villalobos at defensive end. It's a screen pass to the left side. And once again, Navy's defense ready for it. Tackles him for a loss. Now a huge third and 15 coming here. If Navy can hold them to a field goal, if Navy can keep them from getting a first down, they will get the ball and have an opportunity to win this football game with a touchdown.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15.
Tulsa, third and 15. Back to pass goes President. Villalobos causes pressure, and it's incomplete. And as we hoped for, if you're a midshipman fan, Tulsa forced to kick a field goal. It's at the 30-and-a-half-yard line. We'll see if they can make it here. If they don't, Navy only needs, however it is good, a field goal ties it and sends it to four overtimes. A turnover ends this ball game in Tulsa's favor. A touchdown will seal glory for the United States Naval Academy.
25-yard line. It's first down.
Read option on first down. AB on the keeper. He's got the first down. No, he's just a yard short. Going to be every coach's favorite down and distance. Second and one, Navy with options here. In a situation they normally wouldn't have options. A rare opportunity for a little bit of calm. Shotgun wide trips, 3-3-5 on defense. Handoff up the gut to Perry. He dodges the defender, picks up the first down, and a 4 or 5 more. Now going to be first and goal inside the 10. The ball resting at the 9-yard line. The midshipman 27 feet from glory. As the Naval Air Force would say, they're going to try to give him the whole 9 yards. Twin tight end set, single back in the backfield, shotgun for the midshipman, 3-3-5 for Tulsa. Tackled in the backfield, Navy a little bit too conservative for their own good on that play. Tulsa saying, you're going to have to roll the dice if you want to win this football game.
Down.
And the touchdown seals the victory. Navy Malcolm Perry with the score. And in triple overtime, no extra point necessary. The midshipmen escape 45. 48 to 45. In triple overtime, the midshipmen defense answering the call in the third overtime. The offense responding to a pressure situation. And Malcolm Perry, the player of the game, with 109 yards rushing, 109 yards receiving, and 25 carries over 100 yards rushing, including the winning touchdown. And Navy remains in excellent position to make a solid bowl game. Huge victory for the midshipmen. They had a few recruits visiting, and you better believe those high school seniors enjoyed the show. Major victory for the midshipmen over Tulsa, 48-45 the final score, triple overtime. These two teams battling back and forth for the last 27 months. Check that, the last 36 months. Always a close game, always a close run affair between these two teams. These two Western Division American Conference teams. And your Navy midshipmen are victorious, 48-45. We thank you for joining us for the second game of this doubleheader of League One action. An exciting affair to close the night out as Navy emerges victorious 48-45 in triple overtime against the Golden Hurricanes of Tulsa and the outstanding quarter play of Chad President. President did not go out without a fight. Navy had the lead late in the ball game, but Chad President, an excellent 96 overall quarterback, leading the Golden Hurricane to an equalizing touchdown with mere seconds remaining in the ballgame, forcing the overtime. But Navy withstood the force and played well under pressure. Your Navy midshipmen, led by Coach Ninja, emerging victorious 48-45. Our previous game, game one of the doubleheader, saw number 12 Florida State fall victim to number 3 Syracuse, 38-7. We thank you for joining us on this second game. We'll take a quick look now at some end of the game stats. It is an instant classic. Between the two teams, .387 to .363. Tulsa with the edge in yards. Both teams with two turnovers. Both teams with good third down conversions. Both teams with more than 200 yards passing. Both teams with more than 100 yards rushing. It was a tightly contested ball game. But Coach Ninja was able to dig deep and find the necessary plays to get the victory. This will take Navy to 4-3 and 3-2 in the conference. It will drop Tulsa to 4-3 and 2-2 in the conference. A key divisional game as these two teams try to position themselves for a favorable bowl invite. Looking at individual player stats, Zach Abey, the only quarterback with any passing, was 20 out of 24, 83% passing, over 200 yards, 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions. On the ground, Perry with 25 carries for 81 hard-earned yards. Abey contributing 60 on the ground and two touchdowns. In the receiving game, Malcolm Perry, the halfback, with over 100 yards receiving. The player of the game, as voted by the press, justifiably so, picked up 100 yards receiving and nearly 100 yards rushing. For the Navy defense, responding with a couple of turnovers, Julian Haley, check that, Juan Haley, and Kalen Williams, with two key interceptions for the Navy defense when Tulsa was driving to keep Navy in control of the football game. Good plays by Navy's defense, astute play calling by Coach Ninja on offense, led this game in Navy's favor. It took every ounce of effort. It results in a victory. And we will now show you what you can expect to see in next week's football games in League One action. We are now in our 14th season in League One. We've been broadcasting these games on Twitch for quite some time. If you're new to the stream, we hope you'll give us a like and a subscribe and a follow as we look forward to producing many more solid broadcasts for your entertainment. Next week's games for Navy and Syracuse, week 10 of season 14, we'll find Syracuse on the road at Clemson, an excellent football team, your number 3 ranked Syracuse Orange, trying to maintain position for a potential national championship run. Meanwhile, a rivalry game, a battle for the Commander-in-Chief's trophy as the Air Force Falcons travel to Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. Potentially, Navy might wear their Marine Corps uniforms. Going to be a tightly run affair, two teams that like to run the football. A rivalry game, potentially nationally televised, as Air Force comes into the game with a 4-2 record. Air Force Navy, Syracuse Clemson, coming up next week. We thank you for joining us. We hope you have an excellent week. Kick its ass.